Hello everyone, I'm doing Nginx Lab. So basically Nginx Lab is after your Apache. So look, I'm gonna clear my screen. So my Apache server now is running. You know that two web servers cannot run on a one server, but we're gonna learn Docker section how to run multiple web server. But now for this step, if you do service Apache 2 status, look, is running, right? So you do service Apache 2 stop. So now stop. So now you install apt-get install Nginx. So you're gonna install Nginx. So that means that if you now open the browser and do HTTP localhost, look, HTTP, I should just keep that one. HTTP localhost. So you receive basically this page. Why? Because previous lab, if you look at here, I'm here, cd var www.html. Look, I have here index.html. Also have info.php from Apache web server. So if you remove these two files, for example, rm index.html and info.php. So look, now if you refresh the page, it will show up the first page of the Nginx. That means that it will read this file. All right, so that's the first page of Nginx. As I said, do not forget to stop your Apache first. And so here we will learn about configuration of Nginx, nano etc, Nginx, and then nginx.conf, right? So basically here we have the configuration of Nginx that you see here. And then we want to have a reverse proxy for that one. So you go to nano etc Nginx sites available. So for this one also we have site available. mytest.local, we're gonna create this one. It doesn't exist, but we create this one. So here you should put that commands that we have under step 4 in the document. So server, and then listen, port 80. Then we have server, underline name, mytest.local. Do not forget to put semicolon at the end of each line. Location, slash, and then curly bracket, proxy. You're using proxy underline pass, HTTP, www.yahoo.com. And then we have include etc Nginx proxy underline prompts. So I forgot to put here semicolon, okay? And so basically you're gonna close this one and then close this one, okay? I think looks good. So let me save this configuration. If we have any error, we can resolve the issue. So you should also create a symbolic link from which file. Basically, if you see the etc Nginx sites enable, look, we have default file here, right? So I'm gonna create a symbolically ln-s, from sites available. Sites available, my test. So we have my test on local to here, to site enable. So look now, I have my test.local file as a symbolic link here. So then I'm going to change also my etc hosts here. Basically, I put 127.0.0.1 also as my test.local. So that means my test.local is equal 127.0.0.1. So last part is asking, step 7 is asking to systemctl restart Nginx. So you see that I have error. So let's see what is the error. That's a good one that we can also troubleshoot a little. So let's see what is the error. So it's asking you, okay, unknown directive location under etc. So the error is coming from this file. So I'm gonna go to etc. Nginx sites available. So here, if I go to this folders, sorry. Also, we have it here as symbolic link. You can nano my test.local. Because this one is symbolic link, you can change either of them. So this file, look at this file. So I put here location, maybe here is coming from here. Should have a space, proxy underline pass, and include etc nginx proxy underline prompts. Right, so should be good now. So let me now restart my nginx. Look, now it's good. Okay, so then the last part, you should open the tab and do HTTP mytest.local. Local. So basically, if you have like a reverse proxy to yahoo.com. Right, that's lab nginx. So I see you in the next lab.